We are following breaking news out of Israel, where Naftali Bennett says he is ready to join a new coalition government to unseat Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu.
I am announcing that I'm going to work in order to erect a unity government together with Mr. Yair Lapid, my friend, in order to return the state of Israel to its potential.
This creates the potential for a significant power shift in Israel, where Netanyahu has been prime minister for the last 12 years. CNN's Hadas Gold is live in Jerusalem. Hadas, tell us about where the situation stands right now, and what is it going to take for this to move forward?
Well, Jessica, this is a big blow to Prime Minister Netanyahu, and Israel could be seeing the final days of its longest-serving prime minister. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has been in power for 12 years, but with Naftali Bennett, he's the leader of a small right-wing party called Yamina, with him announcing that he is willing to join this new unity coalition, which is made up of a wide swath of parties from left and now all the way to the right. This could mean the beginning of the end for Netanyahu, because Naftali Bennett's support in this sort of anti-Netanyahu block of parties was key to getting them to have the numbers that they need to have the majority in parliament in order to unseat Netanyahu. Now, in a speech just in the last few minutes to the country, Naftali Bennett said that he was doing this, that he was willing to sit with parties on the opposite end of the ideological spectrum from him in order to help prevent Israelis from going to a fifth round of elections in 2 years. He said that he is trying to pull Israel out of the political paralysis that it has been in for the past 2 years, going after round of elections. Prime Minister Netanyahu gave a speech right after Naftali Bennett, saying that Bennett was doing the con of the century, and saying that such a government would be a left-wing government, would be a danger to Israeli security. But although Naftali Bennett has announced that he will be willing to join this new coalition government, this doesn't mean that it's over, because there's a few more steps that need to be done before this government is actually sworn in. Now, the coalition agreements between all of these different parties who are willing to sit together have to be signed, and then it has to be presented to the president and also then voted in parliament and then sworn in. So that means we are a few days away, potentially, before this government being sworn in, and things can change. Things in Israeli politics can change at the last minute, and they can change very quickly. And the numbers here are slim. So one or two defections could completely change the calculations here.
Benjamin Netanyahu has been a most dominant force in Israeli politics for decades. He's been prime minister of Israel for the past 12 years and served an additional three-year stint in the late 90s. But the Netanyahu era may be coming to a close, as a coalition is now being formed to oust him. Joining me now is Tom Friedman, who was once the Jerusalem bureau chief for the New York Times. He's now the paper's foreign affairs columnist and the author of From Beirut to Jerusalem, a classic. Tom, let's posit initially that who knows where this goes, because there need to be seven coalition agreements. Likud's lawyers will look at this. It might even go to court, because it's not clear that you could have Bennett as prime minister if the president had asked Lapid. So there's a lot of complexity, and this may play itself out over days. But what does it mean if, in fact, the Bibi Netanyahu era is over?
Fareed, if it is over, if it comes together with a national unity government in Israel, let me put it in terms that Americans could understand. This is Bidenism coming to Israel. It's a backlash against a leader who developed a personality cult, who basically lived by dividing people, who is extremely allegedly corrupt. He's now on trial for three corruption cases. It's the triumph of people who believe in institutions, the rule of law, and decency. It is the beginning, potentially, of a Biden backlash in Israel.
But let me ask you, Tom, when you look at some of the key figures here, Naftali Bennett is somebody who, on the issue of Israel-Palestine, I think it's fair to say, is more hawkish than Netanyahu. He has said he will never give up the West Bank. He's talked about how he took, he saw nothing wrong with killing Arabs. You have Avigdor Lieberman, part of the coalition. I think you could reasonably say that Lieberman advocates ethnic cleansing of Palestinians, moving Palestinians, who are even Israeli citizens in some cases, off the land. What does that tell us? How should, you know, should we really welcome this?
So I think that if you think this is the prelude to Israeli-Palestinian peace, of course that is not the case. But what Bennett has been a strong advocate of, Fareed, is a very strong autonomy for Palestinians in the West Bank. And I think you could see a consensus forming in this new coalition, this potential national unity coalition, around more separation and more autonomy for Palestinians in the West Bank as a potential stepping stone for something else. Right now, Fareed, the most important thing for American diplomacy and Israeli politics is to keep one thing alive. And right now, it really is in intensive care, the two-state solution. And I see this coalition at least potentially doing that, because I think there is a common denominator for separation and for real Palestinian autonomy and less daily delegitimization of the Palestinian Authority, which was a staple of Netanyahu's politics.
Tom, you've covered the Middle East for 30 years. When you wrote from Beirut to Jerusalem, you know, you were very hopeful about the two-state solution. You advocated it even then. At this point, when you look at the encroachment of settlements, when you look at the radicalization of Israeli politics, when you look at the degree to which Palestinian, you know, dysfunction remains, Gaza being ruled by Hamas, do you understand and do you think that there will be traction for this idea that you are seeing growing on the Palestinian side and with some liberal Zionists like Peter Beinart, that maybe what the only solution here is going to be one binational state in which you give the Palestinians political rights within Israel?
I don't really see that happening, Fareed. I think the best you could hope for, I do think we're in the one-state reality more than we're in the two-state reality, but I don't see it as a one-state reality in which the Jewish majority basically gives full equality to the Palestinian minority if you brought in the 2.5 million Palestinians from the West Bank. But I do think we are in a phase where the dangers to Israel of becoming an apartheid state are becoming so clear. It became clear in the last 2 weeks here. Fareed, you know, we may be seeing in Joe Biden the last pro-Israel Democratic president of the United States, if you look where the rising left in that party is today. And therefore, I think you will see a stronger move toward building more separation and creating a much stronger autonomy and preserving the possibility for a two-state solution. I think that's the most we can hope for right now, but I think that is a possibility with this new coalition.